Hello and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes Blind, A Tear of Vermillion. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're trying to see how we can get to this Kanaphia Island. Sailor Paul says the Planetos is going out to sea again. She's been busy lately. I'm really satisfied right now. I can't wait until we're underway. I'm glad you're satisfied. Are you good and satisfied now? I don't want to get on the boat. I want to check with everyone else first. Sir, Thomas was worried. Sailor Han says he's waiting at the bridge. Which bridge? Not this bridge. Kanata says, ow, ow, why, it hurts. A woman's voice says, there, there, you're a boy. Be strong. Let me see where you got hurt. Kanata is sobbing. Kasmin says, do you think Kanata will die? Will he be okay? He'll be okay, Dr. Bandel says. It's just a scrape. Yay, Dr. Bandel. That's a funny name. It looks like it hurts, so it feels like it hurts. I'll wash off the dirt on your scrape since I'm going to disinfect it. No! That sounds like it hurts. But if you don't get it cleaned, it will keep on hurting. No! Lohidi says, it's okay, I'll distract him, so do it when he's not looking. Hey, Kanata, look! A pigeon is flying! Where? Where? Dr. Bandel quickly cleaned the dirt from the scrape while the boy wasn't looking. You're all okay now. Kasmin says, you cause people too much trouble. Where's the pigeon? Says Kanata. Dr. Bandel says, be careful not to fall anymore. Hey, it doesn't hurt anymore. Avon says, hey doctor, you look like you got your hands full. Oh, Avon, haha, you saw the whole thing? There was a big earthquake earlier. Are you okay? We were inside a cavern, so we had some trouble. Oh, do you have any injuries? That little boy fell in the earthquake and scraped his knee. It's a minor injury, but it made me nervous. Michel says, fortunately, it looks like this town didn't have any major damages. I just hope other towns aren't damaged. Yes, you're absolutely right, Dr. Bale says. I wonder if I should go to the Holy Capital to see how they're doing. Sage Gawain says, that would be great. Thank you. Rutis says, if you're going to the Holy Capital, then we may be able to see you again. Yeah, it'd be nice to see you again, Doctor says. Avon says, there are many monsters on the road, so please be careful. Thank you for the warning. I'll be careful on my way to the Holy Capital. Farewell, everyone. Please be careful about your health. Oh, that was random. It's hard to babysit two kids. Kamsin can say many things, but still only a child. Kasmin says, man, Kanata is too hyper, so he's always getting hurt. Man, man. My leg injury is fine now. I found everyone, so I'm not it anymore. Next is Kasmin's turn to be it. Alright, sounds like a plan. I think there's like nothing there. Oh, it just goes back to the city. Oh, we can get up here. Sailor Bema goes, mmm. Thomas is gonna have a cow if I don't get back soon. Hick! Mr. Gawain, Thomas is waiting for you at the boat. Man, he can keep waiting. Actually, I don't think there's anyone else for me to talk to. Nope. That's it. It's good to know you're safe, Thomas says. I was worried that you were buried alive because of the earthquake. Gawain says, it was close, but I'm okay. Was there any problem with the planetos? A little rumble on land is nothing compared to the shaking during a storm. It seems like there was some problem in the town. Gawain says, there have been a few earthquakes lately, but there hasn't been one this large. I wonder what's going on. Thomas says, oh, by the way, did you find any crimson fire? Excuse me, says Retis. Retis explained to Thomas that the giant crimson fire was lost. I'm sorry, it's my fault, she says. Thomas says, it's not your fault, young lady. There is nothing you can do against catastrophe. But we have to come up with another way. About that, Michel says. I've thought of an interesting idea. Oh? An interesting idea, says Thomas. Can we hear your idea, asks Gawain. Can I borrow your ear, Michel says. No, we need that. Michel whispered to Gawain and Thomas. Hey, no secrets. Share with the class. And that's it, says Michel. Gawain says, I see. Thomas says, that's a surprising idea. Gawain says, it may be difficult, but it may be worth a try. What are you thinking of doing? Asks Avon. Just wait until you get on the ship, Michel says. Thomas says, it's time to set sail on the planetos. Again. What's their plan? They had no reason for them to be whispering and not telling us. At least I don't think so. So, it's all to build up tension and surprise during the game, that kind of thing. Michel says, let's begin. Avon, take the crimson fire you got from the Marquette and put it on the floor. What? But this one won't explode. Just do as Michel says Gawain. Okay, there. Okay, Avon says. Avon, put crimson fire on the floor. Here we go, says Michel. Michel began chanting. What is going on? Sage Gawain, Rutis, cast your spell power into the crimson fire. All right, says Gawain. Yes, says Rutis. What the? Says Avon. Right, now what? It falls back down? The crimson fire became bigger, says Avon. Oh, it did. Michel says, it seems crimson fire is a mineral that grows by taking in the spirit of nature. Well, you weren't sure if it would even work. Why didn't you make it bigger before we got on the boat? Could you imagine if it didn't work? Oh, well, just turn around now. I thought it would also grow if it absorbed a lot of spell power. How'd you know all this? Says Avon. Gawain says, Michel, you keep surprising us. You deserve the name of sage more than I do. No, I just have a curious mind. Thomas says, old man, we're in the area. Old man. Let's do as we planned, says Michel. Thomas, are you ready? Yeah, leave it to me. Avon says, Michel, are you sure you're going? I don't know, Avon, looks like he's going to me. When I was drifting, I felt the line of stratum. Stratum? I'm the right person to throw the crimson fire. Thank you, Michel, says Gawain. Thomas, you be careful too. Leave it to me. I can paddle as well as you do. Michel, are you ready? I can go any time. Thomas says, all right, let's go. A little shaky over there, I see. This is harder than I thought, says Thomas. Yes, says Michel. Hang on for a while. I'll drop the crimson fire. Oh, I didn't even press that. The waves are too strong to get onto the leg. Wow, 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 wow. This is just advancing by itself. I missed some of it. Missed like two lines. Michel says, now! Thomas says, did you do it? Not yet. I'll use my spell to ignite the crimson fire. Hang in there for a while. That's a tough request. Anyhow, I'll stick with you. Ugh. Avon says, did they do it? I'm under control again. Ruti says, look, the waves are subsiding. Right, it worked, Gawain says. Thomas says, whew, I think we've done just fine. You have some courage, don't you? How could you chant when the boat was rolling like hell? I trusted you, Thomas. That's why I could concentrate on my spell. Haha, you won't get anything by flattering me. But now we can finally get to Kanaphia. The Planetos overcame the great obstacle of nature. It turned toward the Kanaphia Island and began moving through the water at full speed. Alright, finally getting over there. A new island to explore. Maybe a town or two as well. Thomas says, farewell, Avon. Good luck. You should have no problem holding the last sacred treasure in your hands. Thank you, Thomas. Thomas, aren't you coming on land? The Planetos is in need of repair because I've been driving her hard lately. I want to repair her while I can. Thanks for your help all the time, Gawain says. All the time. I think by the time Planetos repair will be complete, we'll be done with what we need to do. Thomas says, I'll come and pick you up about that time. Please be careful. Bye! Avon says, now, where was Tsar Shrine? Gawain says, there is a common graveyard to the south of this village. That's where the shrine of the Spirit of Raging Fire is. South of the village. I see. Well, let's get going then. Ruti says, wait, Avon. We'll need the help of the Guardian in order to get in the shrine. We need to find that person first. Oh, I forgot about that little problem. Michel says, hold on a second, who is the Guardian? Ruti says, the Guardians are the descendant of the people who made a pact with the four great spirits long ago. They protect the shrines. The entrance to the shrines can't be opened without their help. I see. Perhaps a Guardian is in this village. Gawain says, no, the Guardian is not here. Avon asks, Gawain, you know the Guardian? Kinda. Leave the Guardian up to me. Well, if we're going to the graveyard, we should go and see the Elder of Kanaphia. Let's head over to the Elder's house. Okay. Where's the Elder's house? Hi. Welcome. Can you go around to the front of the counter? Well, for that I have to leave the shop and come back in this way. Dreadfully inconvenient. Yes, I think I'll be going to the Better Business Bureau about you. Welcome. When it comes to weapons and armor, leave it to me. Who's telling us to leave stuff for them? Swearblade, right? Phantom Killer. Master Brunak. Masterpiece forged by Master Craftsman Brunak. Any swordsman's dream. Lafar Hammer. Large metal warhammer used by two hands. A heavy weapon that breaks large rocks. Octopus Hammer. I guess that's what Gawain has now. Morning Star. I guess it's two-hander. Because his defense and avoidance will go down if we give him that. I guess they both have the Octopus Hammer. Kukri. Kirk's... Wait. I kind of glitched it. Telek. Sword Impulse. Delta Shield. Kirkstein. Famed Pratica? Most powerful sword without a name. No ordinary swords can even mark a scratch. Well, I'll get it for... Do we have 60,000? I thought it was 6,000. Like, oh, no, 6,000. Okay, famed Pratica? We're going to get it for Michel. I just wonder about this magic defense. Verutis is 233. If I give her this, it goes down to 213. What did it say? Sword. That's a shield. It's got the shield icon. I have to check out how far down her magic defense... I think it goes down... Oh, I did see that, right? 213. It goes down 20. I think I'm gonna not get her that, then. Famed Pleiades. Armor born from a coordinated effort of Master Craftsman Ultimate Protection. Okay, for Rutis, definitely, and Gawain... And Michelle, and Avon. Looks like we're buying 4 Fame Pleiades. Still got so much money left. Okay, see you around. It's just funny because... Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch... We're still trying to come up with money now and then. Now we just have more than we know what to do with. Yeah, it's a shield, not a sword. Yeah, I decided not to give her that. Or Gawain. But it's all pluses for Michelle here. Defense up by 7. Yeah, because we have all those brigandins. Kirksteins. This is the one we have 4. Actually, 5 brigandins. Standing there, right? We were over... We were around there somewhere. Hi. I'm sorry, can you go around to the front of the counter? I can't show you all my goods. Ha! I want to see all your goods. Malika says, you guys came on the Planetos, huh? It looks like it arrived late, as usual. Late for what? It's not like scheduled to come here or something. Was there some kind of trouble? Well, I guess they knew about our arrival? Or our impending arrival? Welcome. There are many useful things for sale here. I'll be the judge of that. Drow's charm. Makes the enemy sleep for a while. No, not that useful, I'm afraid. Elder Moralmi says, oh, Gawain. Winia says, oh, Sir Gawain, welcome. This must be the Elder. It's been a while, Elder, Winia. Gawain says, you usually come alone. You have a lot of guests this year, Winia says. Gawain says, yeah, I have things to do other than visiting the grave. Elder Moralmi says, well, don't just stand there. Come on in. Make yourselves at home. I see, the Elder says. The Octum's Apostles started their activity. I hope that a tragedy like what happened 15 years ago doesn't happen again. Tragedy 15 years ago, Avon says. Gawain says, I guess it's about time that I tell you what happened. It's a tragedy that happened on this island involving Durga's daughter. Avon says, but Durga's daughter? Was that girl's name Dominique? The Elder says, Winia, why don't you go to the tool shop for a while? I'd like you to go and buy some flowers to bring to the grave for Gawain. What's a tool shop? Not a flower shop? Yes, Grandfather. Thank you, Winia, Gawain says. Not at all. I'll be back in a bit. She's going to say it when she's out of the house. Such a sad expression, Ruti says. Is something the matter? The Elder says she probably cannot forget about it all, even though it's been 15 years. Winia was very close to Dominique and Madrum. Even says, Dominique and Madrum? Dominique and Madrum were both born in Kanaphia and grew up together, Gawain says. They both joined the Bardas Church when they were 16. They went to go train at Cathedral. Madrum was assigned to train under me as a paladin. Dominique was assigned to train under Alessia as a sister. That was about 20 years ago. 20 years ago, Avon says. That was before I was born. Well, I'm so glad you know how old you are. Gawain says, Madrum absorbed my teachings and became an effective warrior among the Bardas Church. Dominique also spent her days with Alessia, spelled wrong, as a dedicated sister. Everyone thought that the peaceful days at Cathedral will last forever. But about 15 years ago, when Madrum and Dominique just turned 20, Dominique heard Durga's voice. Just like Emel, says Avon. Michel says she was awakened as a priestess of the spirit gods. Yes, says Gawain. I like the song. That was when the Octum's apostles were becoming active due to the traitor Belius. Asperius and I were concerned about Dominique, so we recommended her to hide in her hometown, Kanaphia, and we assigned Madrum to be Dominique's escort. The Elder says we were happy that the two were coming back on vacation since they hardly ever came to visit. It's so sad that tragic events had to occur. I cursed Bardas just that one time. Gawain says, Belius and the Octum's apostles knew that Dominique had returned to Kanaphia. The enemy's elite team assaulted Kanaphia. Madrum ran around the island with Dominique. They tried to buy some time, believing that the church will come to their aid. This was their home, after all. But the aid didn't come fast enough. Why? Says Avon. You were the one that was leading the paladins. Kanaphia's request for aid was eliminated by the abbot of Brazak. That man was interested in bribes and thought the meditation of Cathedral, or the mediation of Cathedral, to be a nuisance. The abbot's name was Avarice. Oh, that's why, says Avon. When I arrived in Kanaphia with the paladins, Madrum was on the ground cradling the body of Dominique. Dominique sacrificed herself to save Madrum from the Octum's apostles. How sad, says Michel. And Madrum entrusted Dominique's body to me and disappeared. That was what happened 15 years ago. So that's what happened, says Avon. Such a sad story, Ruti says. Well, she's back. Thanks for waiting, says Winia. Oh, you're back, says the Elder. Sir Gawain, I brought white lily that Sister Dominique loves so much. This year was full bloom as usual. Winnie handed Gawain a white bouquet. Ah, thank you very much. Shall we head to the graveyard? Gawain says. The shrine of Zar is under the graveyard. Okay, I understand, says Avon. It's raining again on the path of separation, just as though the heavens were sad over that day in the past. Sister Dominique really liked white lilies. Dominique was just like a fragile white lily flower that blooms even in a desolate area. I wonder what the white lily flower means. Doesn't it, like, symbolize death or something? I think it does. Represents purity, innocence, and rebirth. In religious circumstances, they represent the Virgin Mary, also depicted as the resurrection of Christ. It can also represent femininity and fertility. Oh. I learned something today. Well, I'm going to forget it shortly. So, obviously, we've got to look around the rest of the place first. Cash says, Madrim hasn't been back to the village after that day. He probably feels responsible for Dominique's death. I understand how he feels, but that won't make Dominique happy. It's not too late. He should make peace with himself and come back to the village. It's like they were listening in on the conversation. Yeah, here's the blue bandana man, Madrim. Listel says, Dominique was my best friend. We used to play together when we were small. Since Dominique had no family, Madrim was like a big brother. When they both joined the church, I was really lonely, but I knew how Dominique felt about Madrim, so I couldn't stop her. So when they took leave to come back here, I was really happy. But what? Why did such a horrible thing happen? What did Dominique and Madrim do to deserve that? I don't know. Felt like he might say something more now that she said that. But no. This house is pretty big, isn't it? They say that this building used to belong to the Bardas Church. There was a big problem 15 years ago, and a paladin and a sister went missing. It's a waste to just leave it unused, so I've been using it for a few years now. Oh wait, he's got stairs down. I didn't see that. Oh, hello there. What's a counter doing out here? Says Avon. Ruti says, I wonder what store this is, she says. Shifty Merchant says, ha ha ha, welcome. I sell many interesting things here. Feel free to look around. Oh, it's been a while. How have you been? You, says Avon. You're the merchant dude we saw at Beloa. The merchant dude, I like that. You know him, Avon? Says Ratiz. He took care of us a little bit when I met up with Imel. What are you doing here, dude? He keeps saying, dude. This business is just for fun for me. I usually do business here, but when I feel like it, I travel around Elfilden as a traveling merchant. I see, says Avon. Merchant says, how's the cute red-haired little sister? I don't see that good-looking blonde boy. Okay, you've just touched upon two sensitive subjects. Yeah, things have happened, says Avon. Do you still have that earrings that I gave you before? Avon says, do you mean this? I wouldn't lose this thing. Avon took out bond earrings. You only have one. Does that mean your little sister has the other half? Yeah, I think so. I don't know what happened, but your little sister is doing okay. Huh? How do you know? Those earrings have this strange power. If the one who has the other half is in danger, the half that you have is supposed to break into pieces. So your little sister is doing fine, I promise. That's interesting. Really? She's okay? I was so worried about her. Believe me, trust is very important to me. I'll believe you. I feel much better now. Haha, don't worry about it. In any case, it looks like you're in a bit of a situation. I'll get rid of the useless items. I'll get ready items that are useful to you. Okay. I have many useful things for sale here. Alright. Battle wrist. Routisse. Well, I'll buy one for Routisse and one for Gawain. Oh, that's it. Okay. Haha, come again. What the hell is so funny? Oh, it's an upgrade to power wrist, that's why. Alright, power wrist. Attack goes up by 12. Oh, that's his power wrist here, okay. So I need to sell the power wrists. Yeah, by 12. Three of them. All right, done. There's no stairs in the other ones, are there? I barely noticed that one. I guess that's the way to the shrine. Okay. Alright, stay tuned for the next episode where we head for the Tsar Shrine. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.